Hi, my name is Jesus Solorio. I am the coordinator and director for the Allan Hancock College Dance Program. I've been directing for about 5 years, and the Folklorico program for about 3 years now. My role as the coordinator, dance program coordinator, is to oversee anything that has to do with dance, meaning concerts, classes, scheduling, and pretty much everything.
My name is Johnny Flores. I live here in Santa Maria. I've lived here for most of my life. When I was 5 years old, I started dancing Folklorico at Battles Elementary School. And from there, passion grew inside of me for the art of dance, especially Folklorico. Once I got into high school, I started dancing at the Santa Maria High School Ballet Folklorico freshman year. My first time dancing here at Ethel Pope was in 1998. It was a lot of fun, it was crazy.
We all know the step. We just need to make it look more powerful, a little bit more of a swing in the elbows, and just smiling to the audience.
I started dancing at Hancock when I was 16. With Hancock, it was another great experience, very eye-opening. They were a little bit more mature people there, more professional. So it definitely pushed me to step up my game. Summer after my senior year, I decided to travel to Texas to go and audition, and I was lucky enough to be chosen and invited to dance with the National Ballet of Mexico. I danced at a park called Escaret out in by Cancun, and I was there for about a year and a half, and it was the trip and the experience of a lifetime, I have to say. I learned a lot. Again, very professional people, so it forced me to once again like really step up my game, really push harder for what I loved, for my passion.
Comment on is when we're in the diagonal, about to go into the circle, into the trapezoid, to the back. Just that needs to be, we need to watch out.
I came back to Santa Maria, and I started dancing again at Hancock, and teaching and choreographing, and so that was a lot of fun.
With the title of director comes a lot of responsibilities and a lot of good perks as well, but I believe the biggest challenge that I have faced is who we work with and having to figure out who I need to work with, scheduling, and finding the needs for every performer, a middle point to be able to please the dancers on stage, the assistant directors, our guests, and our basically our tech crew all in one, and finding common ground to so that we can make this show happen and look effortless when it goes on, because let me tell you, it is not effortless at all.
I'm 28 years old, and I've been dancing Folklorico since high school. So I was actually exposed to Folklorico early on in my life. I remember when I was a child seeing my parents and relatives participate in Danza de los Hijitos, because we're from Michoacán. So that's where I was born. I was born in Michoacán, and I was also raised there for like the first 10 years of my life. So I grew up seeing them perform in that danza. So I didn't get involved in Folklorico until high school. And it's actually a pretty interesting story, because I was in sports. I love sports. And I remember I was doing volleyball, tennis, track. And then one day I just went to my counselor's office, and she suggested I take Folklorico. And so I joined the beginner's class, and I fell in love with it. Remember learning the steps. I started to fall in love with the history, because my teacher at that time, his name is Artesina Mesqua, and he did a really great job in showing us the history. The biggest advice I can give them is to just give it a try. And I know it's really different. It is a more traditional form of dancing. It's not as modern, but that does not mean that it's boring. It is a great way to connect to not only your roots, but just the customs and the traditions. It's a great way of being able to embrace your culture. We have Righetti High School. We're teaming up with them. We're also teaming up with Corazon de la Costa. And then us, Allan Hancock College. So we're all a group of dancers just trying to tell the story of Mexican people. We love what we do, and we do it with a lot of passion, and we hope that while they're here during the show, that they're able to understand what we're trying to show, which is the story of so many people. We're trying to show our culture, and I hope that they can feel our passion through our dances.
Joana Contreras, soy nacida aquí en Santa María, California, pero mis papás son de Jalisco, de un rancho que se llama El Montoso. So, aunque nacida aquí, muy mexicana. Me gusta cantar.
Yo tuve por novia una joven bonita, la tropa por nombre le puso Adelita.
Que es un sentimiento bonito que ver a la gente emocionarse igual que yo, ejemplo una canción triste, verlos llorar, como que si te sientas como que wow, yo hice eso, yo causé eso, pero a la vez I am so sorry, I didn't mean to make you cry, but it's es un sentimiento muy lindo poder saber que puede llegar a su corazón, igual sentir lo mismo que siento yo al cantarlo y me encanta, me emociona muchísimo y sigo queriendo hacerlo más y más.
Learning how to make menudo and learning how to make tortilla. Oh. So he's like out with my mom on the weekend, like.
He's all dating her, not you.
Yeah, he's the daughter she never had.
Maybe
he also likes her.
My name is Kennedy Frick, and I am the on-set costume vendor as well as managing stage left. I will be in charge of any costume repairs that happen during the performance, any mishaps, as well as managing the dancers on stage left, making sure they're ready and communicating that to our other technical workers.
For 2.5 years, and just within these 2.5 years, it's been fun. You know, of course, you know, we all get tired, you know, our legs hurt, our bodies get broken during the dancing, but I love dancing. I think, you know, it became a very huge like passion of mine, and it made me discover, you know, who I am, and also my love for dancing, you know. Because I was always like a very shy and reserved person, and once I began to dance, then that helped me come out of my shell. And never would I have thought, like maybe like 2.5 years ago, this would be where I am at now. So yeah, I just, dancing is a big part of my life now.
My recent role at the moment is to direct the Ballet Folklorico concert, which usually takes place in May, but this time it'll take place in March. It just gives us a bigger venue, and me stepping into this role is new. There's so much that goes in it: tech, lighting, sound, spacing, costume, and even while we're doing the costume runs, there's a seamstress fixing our costumes backstage while they run off. I need this, please fix it. So they fix it on, and I have to come back on stage two numbers later. And I think it's finding a middle ground, I would say, a biggest challenge, and having to, I don't mean to say please, but finding a middle ground where everybody is satisfied. With Ballet Folklorico, everything is about cheering and living and performing life to the fullest while you're on stage. And not only that, but it invites the audience to participate with cheering, with gritos. It's a wonderful thing. And that's what I look for the most when directing this type of show.
Mis defectos. Tú sí sabes quererme, tú sí sabes adorarme, mi amor. No te vayas, quédate por siempre, para siempre amarte.
Good evening and welcome to Folklorico 2022. We'd like to ask that your courtesy is requested. We remind you that this performance is live. Your actions do not go unnoticed by the performers or your fellow audience members. Please remember that leaving your seat, talking, or even whispering during a performance can disrupt the dancer's concentration and the experience others are enjoying in the theater. Feel free to show your enthusiastic support through thunderous applause. Your enthusiasm will inspire our cast members to perform the best of their ability. Should you need to exit during the show, please ask an available usher to help you back to your seat if needed. We'd like to notify you that El Canelo will not be performed today and to respectfully turn off all cell phones and any other electronic noise-making devices. Reminder that there is no photography or videotaping allowed during the performance. This policy will be strictly enforced, and we thank you for coming and enjoy the show.
Thank you. Hello everyone, my name is Omar. I'm actually 30 years old and I've been dancing Folklorico for the past 16 years. I started dancing at high school with one of the greatest teachers, Artesina Mesqua. I think the biggest challenge is el tiempo, tomar parte de tu día y enfocarte en algo que amas, pero es el tiempo básicamente lo que es un challenge para nosotros, porque pasamos horas y horas y horas bailando la coreografía, los pasos, la forma de que te tienes que presentar, si estás sonriendo, si estás triste, es mucho trabajo que los bailarines ponemos en cada concierto, cada show que hacemos. Creo que uno de los géneros de música que más me gusta, yo creo que es todo. Me gusta desde la banda, las cumbias, el reggaetón, todo me gusta de la música. Yo creo que cada ritmo es diferente y es bonito escuchar la diferente variedad de música que tenemos. Yo creo que en este show la gente va a poder ver el esfuerzo que cada bailarín hace por cada show. Va a ver las diferentes tradiciones y culturas de diferentes estados de México. Al igual, en este año se incorporó nuevos bailes de diferentes tipos, de diferentes estilos de bailes, no nada más folclórico. Puede haber baile contemporal, más estilizado, si se puede decir, pero es un show que va a tener de todo y una variación de bailes y música muy bonita.
Yeah.
tiempo, finalmente sé que estoy dispuesta. Es tan difícil encontrar un amor que aquí me quedo con heridas bien abiertas. Ya no me importa lo que piensan los demás. Aquí me quedo para ser testigo siempre de la vida. Aquí por siempre, para siempre, para siempre amarlos. Corazón, tú sí sabes.
Corazón, tú sí sabes quererme como a mí. My name is Artesin Mariscal Amezcua. I've lived in Nepomo 72 years, but Santa Maria is where I got my first teaching job in 1976. So I've been involved with the community here because of, as an educator, I had many of the students that have gone through my 35-year teaching career. Many of them are now adults, many of them have children, and so I see them often at the store, at community events, at school events, and so also too, I was involved in Folklorico as a Folklorico teacher, and so many of my students that were in the Folklorico also still, many of them continue participating in events. For example, Hancock, when they have their Folklorico, when the high school, Santa Maria, Righetti, when they have their events also too. So the culture is very rich in Folklorico at this time and still continues to grow. Well, Folklorico here at the high schools, I'll talk about the high schools because that's where Folklorico began. In 1974, they started the bilingual program at the high school district here in Santa Maria. At Righetti, they started the program there, and they started with a marimba and ballet folklorico program there. And that has grown and has continued, and from there, it spread to Santa Maria High School. In the late 90s or the early 90s, it started there as a class also. And then when they opened Pioneer High School, it continued there. And even today, it still continues where you have classes and folklorico groups at the three high schools. And also too, not only at the high schools, but in the community, we have some children's groups here in Santa Maria, in Guadalupe. We also have the Padrecito has classes for the community there. So there is an interest, and I just heard that some young man is interested in beginning an adult folklorico. So it seems that the interest is there, and the people, when we do have shows, they support the program because they show up to watch our performers. Thank you.
Are you guys gonna go free? Okay, up here.